We took you all around the 208 in 2021, from the highest peaks.
Yeah, it comes up quite a bit. Where does Hawaii, you know, how do you say it, how do you spell it, and where does it come from?
It comes from a place far away from Idaho. In the early 1800s, the Northwest Fur Company out of Canada went looking for workers from a place legendary British Captain James Cook called Oahe. Around 1818, according to Erics, Donald Mackenzie, working for the company, led an expedition that included three Hawaiians through the Pacific Northwest.
They came into the rugged frontier here, so they really forged up the Columbia River and got all the way up into this border of Idaho-Oregon area, and then he separated his crew.
The Hawaiians were kept together, and that summer were sent off to set up traps. Mackenzie wrote about it in his journal.
His quote is, three Owyhees, spelled the way we spell it, Owyhee, went along a small river to trap where no danger was seen.
But they must have found some. And that's how Idaho's first county came to be named after our country's last state.
And we introduce you to some of Idaho's pioneers.
In Julia Davis Park, you can actually come and have some quiet time. You can have a quiet picnic.
Julia became known as the Welcome Wagon of Boise, helping immigrants traveling on the Oregon Trail who stopped along the river to rest.
She was a really, really nice lady. She would come down to the park, which was still an apple orchard, and bring things for the pioneers.
They grew apples, and it was really conveniently located next to the river for irrigation.
That orchard was prone to flooding, and Tom considered conferring it to the city for its first public park.
And so finally, when Julia died, Tom said, "You will take the park and you will name it after her, and it will forever be known that."
And to some of the more interesting characters.
It started as the territorial prison in 1872, a rather rough house in those early days. But by the early 1950s, the old Idaho State Penitentiary had mellowed, mostly. Entered Dennis the Cat. In June of 1952, a prisoner serving a life sentence smuggled the black tomcat into house 2. Sure, there's a no pet policy, right?
Absolutely. I mean, they had been keeping him secret. They had been keeping him hidden. They'd been sneaking him snacks, sneaking him food.
Of course, it wasn't long before the guards discovered Dennis, and then the warden got wind of him, who would only allow Dennis to stay if the convicts could keep their cool.
We learned the Blue was actually an airstrip before it was the Blue.
Meanwhile, Boise was growing, and so was its first institute of higher learning.
So Boise Junior College had been leasing space on the north side of the river, and when this opportunity arose, they relocated to the south bank and built their first administrative building and, you know, added some dormitories and classrooms over time. And so eventually the use of that airstrip, it ceased. And so in 1936, thereabouts, the decision was made to officially relocate the Boise Airport to Gowan Field.
But the original airfield was still on school grounds. That is, until Boise Junior College needed to build a football field. And one could say the Broncos took control of the airspace after that.
And that someone actually sent their kid through the mail ticket to grandma's house.
That sidestep the train ticket mentality led to other peculiar parcels perceived by parents. Oh yeah, people passed their kids along with the postman. 7 times between 1913 and 1915, according to the National Postal Museum. One of those times was one of the last.
She is known as Mailing May, a little girl that was shipped through the mail, through the postage system.
5-year-old Charlotte May Pierstorf lived in Grangeville, Idaho. Her grandmother lived in Lewiston, but getting them together would cost too much by train.
It was nearly 3 times as expensive to buy her a train ticket as it was to buy the postage to mail her to Lewiston.
So that's what they did. On February 19th, 1914, May Pierstorf was sent packing, sort of, with postage pinned to her coat.
53 cents.
To mail a child.
Oh, Miss May still made the 73-mile commute on the Camas Prairie Railroad, just in the mail compartment instead of the passenger part.